I haven't been here since 2019.
It's 2025. I'm taking my entire team to the largest networking conference in the world, Cisco Live.
Hey, network babies.
This is 22,000 people gathering in one place to talk about one thing: networking, cybersecurity, IT. There's no other event like this, and it happens every year. But this year, it feels different. There's kind of a heaviness in the air because of the obvious thing, AI. It felt like everyone was coming to this to find answers, get direction. What should we be doing? But you know, that's not a new thing for Cisco Live. In fact, that's kind of why it exists. In fact, I still remember my first Cisco Live, and I didn't even attend it. It's 2017, and I'm sitting in my cubicle as a newly minted senior network engineer. I just poured the crappiest cup of corporate coffee you'll ever taste, but it didn't matter. I was so excited. On my second monitor, instead of working like I should have been, was the live stream of the opening keynote of Cisco Live. This thing was cool. They opened with thunder from Imagine Dragons. They had these LED balls moving in sync with the music around the stadium. And the CEO Chuck Robbins took the stage to tell us all about what was new with networking that year. I was so hyped. I felt like I had the coolest job in the world. Because I did, let's be honest. A job that barely anyone knows about, which is part of the allure of Cisco Live. We get to hang out with people who understand what we do. And I begged to go to Cisco Live that year. I'd never been. But my job said no. You see, it's normally your job that will pay you to go. It's $3,000 for a ticket plus travel and accommodation. I couldn't afford that. Which is why Cisco will give you a how to convince your boss to go email template to fill out and send to your boss, which I did. They still said no. But these guys, they had more success than I did.
Well, download the official Cisco recommendation template, then zhuzhed it up a little bit with AI, and hey, we're here.
And then I copied him, and yep.
In fact, I think most people are there because their company paid them to go. Which is such a strange thing, right? A strange thing that I took advantage of in 2018 and 2019. I actually went to Cisco Live those years, and let me tell you, it lived up to the hype. I encountered a thing, an event, a community that changed me. But then I didn't go for 6 years. And for some reason, I'm coming back in 2025. Why? I think I want to discover that spark, that excitement that I had back in 2017, the love for networking. I want to find that again. So I was hoping that at this event, I would find it. Now, as I'm walking the halls of the San Diego Convention Center, which is where Cisco Live was held this year, and I saw all these people who are as excited as I am to be there, it got me thinking, how did this happen? How did this start? And it turns out it hasn't always been called Cisco Live. The first Cisco Live was called Networkers. It's 1989. 200 people are crammed into a stuffy hotel conference room in Palo Alto, California. At that time, computer networking was still a new thing, ahead of its time, kind of like AI is now, which is, you know, it's kind of weird. It feels like this year maybe shares some similarities with the first Cisco Live. This guy had actually been to Cisco Live before it was called Cisco Live.
So your first, that Cisco Live, like a long time ago, like 1995, what was
yes.
it like? And it wasn't called Cisco Live, was it?
No, it was Networkers.
Networkers.
Yes.
What was it like? How is it different from now?
Oh, a lot of different topics.
Yeah.
And the protocol wars were raging. Max chatting over Apple Talk, Novell file servers blasting IPX, Vax customers on DeckNet, Banyan Vines keeping email alive. Most of you have no idea what I just said. I barely did. And while TCP/IP eventually won, enterprises in the 80s were still running all of these different protocols and were having trouble figuring out how to make them work together. And that was the very problem Cisco was trying to solve. You see, they had just come out with their Cisco AGS, a multi-protocol router. But it was kind of complex to explain what it did. They needed a big whiteboard session just to tell everyone and teach everyone, and that's what this event was. A giant, nerdy whiteboard session. But this wasn't just a big plug for Cisco. This was the pioneers of networking getting together to figure out how to make the network work. It was half summer camp, half Apollo mission war room. Knowledge is power is what the CEO at the time, John Morgridge, would say. This whole thing was put on to share knowledge. And this event was rare because customers were interfacing with the very developers and creators of the products they were using. They were even giving feature requests, features that would later show up in iOS versions later that year. But it wasn't just knowledge they were sharing. They were sharing community. They were building a community. And I'm not sure they knew it at the time, but they were building one of the strongest tech communities out there.
Hey, it's time for a coffee break. My coffee's right here. Hold on. This coffee break and this entire video is brought to you by our sponsor, TwinGate. TwinGate, if you've been watching me for a while, you're not new to them. But if you're not using them, you're crazy. We could not get here, be here, and do things at Cisco Live without TwinGate. They keep us connected back to our studio. I brought my entire editing team here to make videos, and let me tell you, we have a lot of assets back at our studio that we have to access. TwinGate keeps us connected. Actually, hold on, right here, right now. On my phone, I got the TwinGate app, connects me back to my studio. Super simple, super easy. Can I tell you something else? Right before I was leaving, this is story time. Right before I was leaving, my TwinGate servers, the servers that I had running TwinGate, died. Two Proxmox hosts, power outage as I'm leaving for my flight. Thankfully, TwinGate makes it stupid easy to deploy a connector and get access to everything you need, just like this. What's cool though is like, it's not VPN, like remote access VPN, where you'd have to deploy a firewall appliance, add config, no. You just drop in a quick command, run it in Docker, run it in Linux. It's amazing. It took me like 10 seconds. So if you're not using TwinGate for remote access, you're crazy. Huge shout out to TwinGate. They are a vendor I trust, I use every day, and they've been a long-term sponsor of my channel. So if you aren't using them, check them out, show some love. Coffee break, over.
By the mid 90s, attendance had grown to the low thousands, and they held multiple events in the US and in the world. Yeah, they had gone global. It kept getting bigger year after year, peaking in 2019 with 28,000 people in attendance. That was my last Cisco Live. It became an event that you couldn't miss if you were in this space. And while it started with a focus on sharing knowledge and building community, it also kind of became an escape for nerds. They had these giant customer appreciation events with some big names like the Blue Man Group, Weezer, Journey, Imagine Dragons, Lenny Kravitz. This year they have the Killers. They would even have famous people come to these, people who I don't think even knew that networking was a thing, like my favorite actor, Bryan Cranston. Heisenberg came to Cisco Live. They even rented out Harry Potter World one year. I was there and it was amazing. And Cisco Live is also known for announcing big things, many things being a first for the industry. For example, in 1993, they debuted the CCIE certification, the first expert level networking certification. In 1998, they announced the CCNA and the CCNP. That's a big deal. The CCNA is still the best IT certification in the world. In 2006, 2007, things started to change. This is when it went from networkers to Cisco Live. They're kind of shifting from being just a pure training bootcamp to being more of a trade show. This is where we first saw the World of Solutions, which you can see right here. It's just full of vendors giving away free stuff and showing the things they're making, which this year it was AI. It's everything AI, which added to the eeriness of the event. In 2015, they announced the DevNet Zone, creating a space for developers, not just network engineers, to come and hang out. And then in 2017 and 2018, we see these roles start to merge. Intent-based networking, IBN, was a thing. Cisco announced their DNA Center and SD-WAN. It was that year that Susie Wee took the stage and told us that we are all now developers, which scared me to death. In 2019, they refreshed all their certifications, announcing the DevNet track. And then something happened in 2020 and there was no conference, virtual only. They had massive numbers, but it wasn't that in-person experience that people were used to. And it turns out people actually needed it. We didn't see Cisco Live come back to an in-person event until 2022. And now here we are in 2025. The attendance hasn't fully recovered since before COVID. This year we're gonna see again 22,000 people. But I will say, the excitement, the community, it's very much alive, it's here. And even though it's been 6 years since I last came to a Cisco Live, coming back, I'm excited. The community, they just embraced me again. Honestly, I was overwhelmed. Seeing old friends, making new ones. This is probably the coolest IT community I've ever been part of, and I've been part of others. Now, the Cisco Live of today is a mix of education and community. Normally when you come, if you've never been to a Cisco Live conference or any kind of tech conference, you have community events, then you also have sessions, technical sessions, where you'll go to learn the latest and greatest things. These are actually extremely valuable. When I was a network engineer, I would watch replays of these events. They would make them freely available after the event to learn how to do stuff.
Oh, I think I learned more in the 6 days I was at Cisco Live than I did the rest of the year. So, I mean, I took it in and went to a bunch of sessions and learned quite a bit. So,
like you just said, you often do learn more in 1 week than you will the entire year, which is why companies do pay to send their employees to come. It's worth it for them. It's a time for you to step away from the busyness of your job, where you barely have time to think sometimes, and you get a chance to look at the industry as a whole. You get to exchange ideas with your fellow network engineers, increase your skill set, and learn how to do your job better. And I'm telling you, these people aren't playing around. That's what they're actually here to do. I brought my friend Rachel with me, and looking around, she said, "This feels like one big brain. Like everyone's here to just learn, you can tell." That's the energy of this conference. It's the nerdiest, most wonderful place, I'm telling you. It's so fun. And I asked many people, we were interviewing people, like, "Hey, why do you keep coming back to Cisco Live?" because many people come over and over and over again. And while many will say they come for the sessions to learn stuff, that's definitely a key thing. The main thing they come for is the community, the friends they've made and the new friends they hope to make.
Relationships are so valuable. Just connecting with people. Coming to Cisco Live, you start forming those connections with people that you never get, even when you're doing video calls and things like that. And I mean, I know I've already met a few people that I'm like, man, I think you and I should link up after this and figure out where this relationship could go.
It's a great experience. Mm. Interacting with other people, the networking is wonderful. Talking to people like yourself, I think is a great thing. Seeing friends and the learning.
Cisco Live is one of those events where now here I get a chance to meet in real life, you know, all of the remote networks that I made,
Okay.
And kind of renew those, kind of a yearly hello message, if you will.
Okay, so now, Cisco Live 2025. Did it change me? Did it light that same spark I had back in 2017 sitting in my cubicle with a crappy cup of coffee? Yeah. I think it did. Being there, physically there, with all these people who love technology and networking, the excitement, the joy, it's contagious. David Bumble made a joke during our interview. He's like, oh, are you gonna be putting the network back in NetworkChuck? Because I kind of, you know, taken a field trip to other technologies on my channel, hacking, home labbing. I still talk about networking from time to time, but it's kind of taken a backseat. But I gotta tell you, this event has made me fall in love with networking again. It's reminded me the importance of a network for everything now, especially with AI. Like with AI, they need us more than anybody else now. AI will be nowhere without the switches and the routing that make everything connect and work. And while there was some uneasiness about AI and what it might do to the industry, our jobs, which I touch on in this video here, overall, people were excited, ready to learn that next new thing, sharpen their skills. And those are the people I want to be around, the people I want to associate with. So I think I will start making networking content again. That's what Cisco Live did for me. And I probably, definitely, yes, I'm going to go to Cisco Live 2026. I think it's in Vegas. I'll be there. I would love to see you there. If I met you this year, I would love to meet you again. Let's do another photo. And if you've never been before, try and make it there. Trust me, you will not regret it. That's all I got. I'll catch you guys next time.